Hi there, friends. Welcome back to 7times.com here on Paint Man Show. Still with your friend here, Bernie Kutsuchan, inviting you to stay tuned. Watch for another personality that we are going to feature tonight. So stay where you are, or gotta sleep. This time, friends, we are proud to have with us another dignitary, the one which I promised you a long time ago to be with us, but he has been with us once, and this is the second time that you shall view him with us, exchanging his thoughts, his views, his insights, and all this, which I believe would inspire all of us tonight. This time, this man needs no further introduction. He's a very dedicated public servant because his heart belongs to the people. The guy whom I believe would be able to help change the landscape of Zamboanga City. The one who will be given this opportunity. Once given this opportunity, I believe we shall be able to make the necessary reform for the best interest and welfare of the Zamboangueños. A true-blooded Zamboangueño, a man who will give a good a fight in this coming 2013 election in the congressional district which he represents. And without much ado, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our friend, our very own, Mr. Samuel Francisco Enanzando. And I call him Sam. Sam, welcome.
Buenas noches, amigo.
Yeah. Welcome, yes, Portugal.
Of course, buenas noches. Un saludo a mga compoblanos y vivientes de Zamboanga, especialmente en el Distrito 2. So, este interview, ya dale conmigo opportunity, el online program de Mr. Mi amigo, si Bernie Concepcion. And with this, I think we can start something for the good and betterment of the second district of Zamboanga City.
Okay, Sam, I have to mention second district, Sam. You've been here and there, you've been a very busy man, I know you. Doing many things for the good of Zamboanga, despite the fact you're not a them, but you're here. Now, tell me what you're doing now. Tell me what.
At the moment, from yesterday, that last day of filing of certificate, maybe you were there,
yeah,
in the grandstand. So I went to the grandstand to file my certificate of candidacy in the second district, together with my wife, my family, my supporters and leaders in the second district. So I belong now to the Partido ng Manggagawa at Magsasaka. In short, these are the Workers and Peasant Party. This is a national organization. The chairman here is no less than the former secretary of the Department of Public Works and Highways, who was supposedly the next president of the Republic of the Philippines. Had it not for him who withdrew personally in the race to give way to our incumbent president, Benigno Simeon Noynoy Aquino. I'm referring to the former secretary of the DPWH, the Honorable Hermogenes Ebdane Jr. Now, El Yaton, governor in the province of Zambales in northern Luzon.
That's a twist.
Or belonging to Region 3.
Okay. So, Sam, you've been very visible, even not during election time. So you've been doing many things. You've been doing extra service to our people. So you've been involved in any activities. Yeah? Tell me some of these activities.
You see, as officers of a civic organization, and are actually assistant governor of na Rotary International District 3810, and with my experience also as a former JCs of the Pinaklabanan, San Juan Pinaklabanan JCs. So practically my whole life was involved in service to humanity. Oh, yes. So in Rotary we call it the service above self. Yes. So these are my passion,
yes.
And to go everywhere, including in the Central District, to give services to our people.
So you are among those who flagged your certificate of candidacy, and I think you have reason, a very great reason, why you wanted to join the political arena in your district as a congressman.
Si, bueno man kay, that's good you asked that question. Kay, tiyan nga natin ta pregunta, por que pa man necesita pa ka to correr? Twice daw yaman, attempt yun, tan apart to run, pero I lost. But you see, we have to admit that in the first fight of my congressional race, it was the newly created second district of Zamboanga City. Before it was only a long district. Now, long district congressman, the first term of congressman is our congressman R.B. Fabian.
Oh, incumbent.
The incumbent. Oh. So the incumbent congressman in the during the long district. Yes. Then when we divided into two, so R.B. belonged to the area of District 1. Oh. So it's really a big, very slim chances for us to win because he is already serving in Congress. So I tried again in 2010. Now this the last term of Congressman Fabian, hoping that we can make it. But yet, you know, we're fighting a big a political figure like him, so it's very hard to go into winning age. So this time, since he is a last term in congressman, so he is running for mayor, this is the very opportune time. And I think this the third time I am running now, this will definitely give me the opportunity to get the second district of Zamboanga City.
So this is your time now.
This is my time. I consulted my family, you know, we have a big family in the city of Zamboanga. Grandes, eh? So right now I'm the president of the Luna clan, which is the biggest family involved in the original family,
Latino,
where we belong. So all of them are behind, and they give their approval for me to run. Of course, you know, at present, hindi kita pwede man-disturb kanila, yeah, because all of them are very busy, yeah, nagtrabaho tamen.
But at least they know that you are here.
Yes, they know already. Have
backing, so
they have the backing. In fact, yesterday when I filed my certificate of candidacy using the color t-shirt, they were all my families behind. Okay. So 200 of them or 150 of them who were present yesterday.
Okay, so we'll have more exchanges. We just pause for a break. We'll be right back, friends, here on Late Night Show with Sal and Alexander. Stay with us.